Welcome to MWC 2024. Today I'm delighted to host Nazim Benhadid, Telus Chief Technology Officer. We will discuss the latest telco industry trends and the role of network cloudification. But before we dive into our discussion, let's take a moment to introduce ourselves. My name is Sameh Naguib. I lead the global business development and go-to-market strategy for AWS Telco Network. My team work with the industry ecosystem across CSPs, ISVs, and GSIs to transform the way mobile networks are built and operated by leveraging AWS. I look forward to working with you, Nazim, as we embark on our joint network cloudification journey.
Thank you, Sameh. My name is Nazim Benhadid. I'm the Chief Technology Officer for Telus. I have the honor and privilege of leading the team that is responsible for our technology journey. Let's start the conversation.
Let's reflect on the evolving landscape of communication. At AWS, we believe the transformation of CSPs from telco to techco is an opportunity to redefine connectivity and digitize industries. From your perspective, how do you envision CSPs embarking on this transformation, and what implication does it hold for the industry?
I think it's one of the both challenges and opportunities facing our industry. You know, for the longest time, we were the preferred choice to provide reliable voice, data, and connectivity services. And we've done that really, really well to the benefits of our customers. Now, we have an opportunity to go beyond that. There's a very, very large ecosystem that's being built where connectivity plus information technology plus data are enabling future use cases that will truly transform our society. At Telus, we deeply believe in that. And if you look at our strategy over the last 20 years, you know, we've moved from being a regional telecommunication provider to being a world company now present in over 100 countries. And we branched out from telecom to healthcare to ag tech and so on and so forth, because we believe that the combination of those three items together will help provide remarkable outcomes for people. But the challenge is both a technical challenge and a cultural challenge for us. Technical challenge because of our size, because of the fact that we are an industry that was very much bespoke in the technologies we used. If you look at the telco industry, we're a fraction of a fraction of the size of the IT industry. You know, you coming from a hyperscaler, I'm sure will appreciate that. But it's also a cultural shift because it requires to be in a world where everything is open, everything is in a rapid innovation, and everything is in a risk-taking environment, which in our industry is not what we do. What we do is really five nines, reliable, predictable, long-term investment, and so on and so forth. But the opportunity is here. We look at it in our AgTech business, for example, where we enable our customers through all kinds of technology and data to be able to manage their crop remotely and do all their operations as if they were completely virtualized, or in the healthcare in the same way. So we're actually very, very excited, about that.
Thank you for sharing your perspective, Nazim. Your insights provide a very valuable view on the nature of this transformation. At AWS, we believe that 5G is actually pivotal to enable this transformation. So how do you envision 5G shaping the future of your consumers and enterprise customers?
I think, so first of all, 5G, evolution of all the other Gs, really is the first time where we have the combination of high speed, low latency, and massive connectivity. These three things together help us provide industries, and when I say industries, it's a very broad term. Like, it could go from manufacturing to mining resource to healthcare, as I mentioned, or ag, the ability to remote monitor everything they have. We are already starting to see changes, for example, in healthcare, especially in a country such as Canada, very, very large country, low population density in some areas, very remote, where remote patient monitoring, access to patients' data from anywhere is actually transforming that type of industry. We're seeing in the mining industry completely automated operations, great for safety of workers, great for predictive maintenance and so on and so forth. And it's really the foundation. 5G provides the foundation for such operations. In addition to that, the challenge with the wireless network has always been that it's a shared network. And it was in the past very difficult to provide dedicated SLAs or quality of service. But now with the introduction of slicing, we actually have the ability to prioritize, reserve resources to specific use cases, to specific enterprises, for specific moments in time, so that they can have the connectivity that best serves their needs at that very moment. So today, the technology as a foundation is there to support the innovation that will come from the ecosystem of partners that we're working with.
Yeah, absolutely. And we actually believe that the collaboration between hyperscalers and communication service providers is key to unleash the full potential of 5G. And in fact, the work we do together, our collaboration in network cloudification, is a good example of that. So from your perspective, what are the benefits of network cloudifications, and how network cloudification can enable networks to achieve even more?
So if you look at the journey of the telecom network functions over the last 10 years, we had a cycle of virtualization, which, in my opinion, provided benefits, but not the full benefit of truly virtualized network. And that's because historically, telecommunication network function providers weren't completely embracing all the benefits of the cloud. Now we're at a point where we're starting to see that. And a few benefits that we're observing and that we're already banking on. First one is really on-demand capacity. Having the capacity you need real time when your customers need it. Secondly, I'd say, reliability and resiliency of the cloud. Thirdly, the openness of the cloud ecosystem and the ability for all kinds of new players to enter into the networking world and provide all kinds of new use cases for us to work on. We've built our private clouds on our own, and that served us for a period of time. But I think as an industry, we're now ready to start branching out into the public cloud. And at Telus, we believe that the time is right for the right use cases. And that's why we're pushing ahead with that.
Yeah, and we share a common vision on this. We also believe that adopting cloud native principles and practices is very important and is key to actually enable this transformation and to get the benefits of cloudification. We also believe that automation is very important and is key in this new network paradigm. So from your perspective, how do you see automation and cloud technologies driving the future of network operations?
I think they're absolutely necessary, especially if you project yourself a little bit into the future. The number of network functions that is introduced by 5G as the number of use cases increases, grows in a non-linear way. It would be absolutely inefficient and I dare to say foolish to believe that we can manage that without being fully automated, and for two reasons. Number one is from an efficiency perspective, as I said, it's non-linear, so if you were to do it the old way, eventually you will drain your business. But secondly, from a reliability and resiliency perspective, because human error will increase with the number of elements that that come with it. So automation provides that stability, that steady pace of growth that you can deal with. But secondly, and maybe more importantly, automation and cloud are the two foundational elements for AI and machine learning, because as the networks become more and more complex and are expected to be more and more reliable, only uh, or the opportunity is here to have AI and you know, train your models in a way that goes from reactive resiliency to really proactive resiliency and taking care of issues before before they happen, and you know, ensuring that your customers have the best network performance at all the time. And it's something that we're already seeing, you know, in the projects that we have together for the local gateway and the breakout, where we were able in less than 2 weeks to completely, in an automated way, instantiate a network function in a different country and start making calls and data services. If it wasn't for the combination of cloud or automation, we would have been talking about months versus a couple of weeks. So we think that's the way.
Yeah, I can't agree with you more. And this speaks volume to the importance of having the right culture as we do this transformation together, and the importance of working with the right independent software vendors, network, or as we call them, network ISVs. So let's talk about this collaboration. So our collaboration with you, with CSPs in general, extends also to working with ISVs who adopt cloud native principles. How do you see these ISVs and this partnership playing a role in enhancing the 5G ecosystem and contributing to the overall goal of CSPs?
I think it's critical. I mentioned earlier, that it's an ecosystem. We believe that three types of player are critical for the success. An infrastructure provider such as yours, such as AWS, that can provide both infrastructure and expertise. Connectivity providers such as us, that can, that has the desire to transform and to continue connecting their customers. And ISVs who have both the expertise to build on cloud-native principles and the risk-taking to go and displace existing software providers, telecommunication software providers, who for too long have enjoyed a position of locking in their customers. Cloud-native software, network functions, are not that common. And when we find them, we really try to work very hard to grow them, because they're more efficient, they're open, which allows us then to go and work with them to build on additional use cases and automation and all of that, and they're efficient. At the end of the day, what we're looking for is ISVs who can build software that consumes the least amount of resources to provide the best possible service. And when we find them, we partner with them, and we had, again, same thing for the local breakout. We did the same thing. We're trialing one of those ISVs, and we're very, very happy with what we're seeing. Truly, truly transformational.
Yeah, and we spoke earlier about the transformation from telco to techco, and I think this provides the foundation. So from AWS perspective, not only we work with network ISVs, we also created a large ecosystem of application ISVs, which we continue to grow and we bring to the table, because we believe that as you go up the stack and you transform your business, this will be key to monetize 5G and other use cases. Let's talk about a different topic. Let's talk about sustainability.
Yes.
As you know, Nazim, Amazon co-founded the Climate Pledge in 2019. And we committed to have zero net carbon emissions by 2040. Since then, we made significant strides into powering our operations with 100% renewable energy. And we are on track to achieve our goal by 2025, which is 5 years sooner than planned. So from your perspective, how can network cloudification play a role in contributing to Telus sustainability efforts and goals?
So first of all, I think one of the reasons that we're working together is that we're aligned, from a values perspective. We are committed to being carbon neutral by 2030, and we're going to be there before that date. And we do a lot of effort to, at the same time, decarbonize, but also be more efficient, so that both the communities where we live and our shareholders get the benefits of this effort. And I think cloudification with the right partner gets us there as well for two reasons. Number one is when you move into the cloud with a true cloud native software, then you don't need excess capacity. And as telecommunication providers, you know, we have to design for peak time, but peak time is not all the time. So this allows us to remove waste of excess capacity. And then when we run our workloads into an environment that is already, you know, with renewable energies and all of that, and you're more efficient financially because you don't consume excess capacity, then I believe we can get the best of both worlds. So, yeah.
I mean, can't agree with you more. Another thing that we see with various customers, when you look at new technologies like ARM, for example, they bring a lot of promise in terms of power consumption reduction. And we see customers across various industries using more of our Graviton-based instance because they can get better price performance and they can get lower power consumption. In fact, one of our telco industry partners recently demonstrated 72% when they ran their core network on Graviton-based instance. So this is an important area.
It is something that we're definitely looking on. I mean, the evolution of compute is something that will make a difference. We've seen that when we virtualize, you know, when moving from purpose-built CPU to, you know, x86 architecture, we've seen an increase in power consumption, especially at the very beginning. And, you know, I'll come back to something that we mentioned, right? Like, that's why cloud native is important to get started, is to consume the smallest possible footprint. The next generation is really, how do you go into a chipset that is natively, more efficient, thought of in a way that's more efficient from an energy perspective.
Makes sense. So finally, Nazim, you have been in, I would say, the forefront of innovations, leading Telus team, and Telus is known for its engineering excellence. And we have been working together on this journey. But you know very well that network cloudification is a significant undertaking. So what advice would you give to your fellow CSP technology leaders who are considering embarking on a network transformation journey?
I think, so it depends on your starting point. But at the end of the day, we are in the business of technology. So the first thing you have to look at is the business and find the value. What use case is small enough to get you started and learn and, you know, get your team comfortable with a public cloud environment, but also comes with high value for the business? You start with that. And in our case, you know, we've had long conversations around this, and we landed on the local breakout roaming gateway. We wanted to make sure that we found something that could improve our customers' experience right away, that was small enough so that we can actually understand it and digest it, and it's low risk, but it's also foundational to take us to where we want to be, you know, in the future of our journey. So I would start with something small like this, you know, DR in the cloud, local breakout, learn from it, grow it, adjust, grow it again, adjust, and so on and so forth. That's, in our case, what we found, to be the most efficient way to tackle this journey.
Nazim, this was a great conversation. I truly enjoy working with you and with your great team. And I look forward to continuing our network cloudification journey. And I wish you a wonderful time at MWC.
Thank you very much. This was very pleasant, and looking forward to our continued collaboration.
Thank you, Nazim.
Thank you.